Hello everyone, I am Lokesh and welcome back to the channel. So friends, this video is all about TCS March NQT Special Edition Interview Experience. And in the particular video, Mr. Ritesh shared his interview experience that he recently cracked the TCS recruitment process and interview process. So in the particular video, we see the particular description or detailed process about the TCS Ninja virtual interview experience that is according to the March NQT, because my NQT is scheduled in some days and we have to prepare for the exam and also for the interview. So let's in the particular video, the Mr. Ritesh Pandey shares his interview experience, and in the particular video, we will cover the different parts that is related to the introduction, or I can say that NQT details, or the next part is related to the rounds and panel, and the next part related to the interview. What are the some tips and suggestions to crack interview and feedback for the online learning channel? What Ritesh cracked the TCS interview process, and in the whole during process, what our channel will help in the whole during interview process. So basically, introduction about the TCS is related to the, we all know about the TCS. TCS Tata Consultancy Services Limited is an Indian multinational information technology services. As we know that TCS conduct every year many recruitment for the freshers batch as well as for the graduates batch. So firstly, I would like to thanks Mr. Ritesh. Okay, thanks. Thank you, Mr. Ritesh, for coming to our channel and sharing your interview experience. It would be very helpful to candidate for crack the interview and recruitment process. Thanks, Ritesh.
Thank you,
Ritesh,
sir. Thank you, Online Learning Channel.
Okay, welcome.
To share my interview experience on your channel. On
yes, welcome.
And congratulations you to, first of all.
Thank you so much.
You completed 10K subscribers on the
channel. Yes, yes.
Because
yes.
Your content is too much.
Thank you so much.
So, first of all, I want to introduce myself. My name is Ritesh Pandey and I have completed my MCA in 2020 batch.
Okay.
I had applied for TCS Ninja, that is, and my salary package is 3.6 MCA.
Okay.
And I have selected from TCS NQT exam. And
okay.
My interview location and date was 10 March. I have applied for TCS NQT that was held on 10th of March. And interview process is done on virtually.
Okay.
From my so
yes.
Yeah. So first of all, I would like to explain the NQT details, like how we go from the NQT. So in the NQT, there are two sections. First is in which we divide three parts, that is numerical ability, verbal ability, and listening ability. So in the numerical ability, there are 26 questions and time limit is 40 minutes. So in the numerical ability, we have also a calculator option in that examination. So we have to solve the questions from calculator that will be good for us because it saves our time. So
yes.
In the verbal ability question, there are some 24 questions and time limit is 30 minutes. And in the reasoning ability, the number of questions are 30 and the time limit is 50 minutes.
Okay.
So these three parts we have to do. And after that, from the coding section, there are from 15 minutes of time for 10 questions of programming logic. The questions are very simple, like we have to solve the question and find out what will be the output of that program, or some of the concept or some concept or functions are there in the question. That is too much easy, I think, for if we have any programming language knowledge, then we can solve that question.
Yes.
And in the second section, there are two coding questions, hands-on. That in the first question, we got a question like that is not too much hard.
Okay.
And the second question will, yeah. So first question we can solve in 15 minutes. There is no time limit is divided in 15 or 30 minutes. So total 45 minutes is divided for these two questions. We have to solve both, but if we can solve any of one, then it will be also good.
Okay, so this part is the numerical ability, yeah. Verbal and reasoning ability part in some the cognitive section, and this is the programming
yeah.
part. So it is very important to understand the basic process that is related to cognitive and the IT programming.
Yeah.
Yes.
So according to my research,
yes.
if we solve any one of the coding section, then also we can qualify the interview.
Okay.
Qualify for the interview section. Yeah.
Yes.
And if we score 60% plus for in NQT, then we will in qualifying for the interview.
Okay.
According to my research. On
so the 60% criteria is basically in the cognitive. Yeah. And if you solve the particular one questions from the particular two questions, so you will be hands definitely on. Okay. Hands-on question. Okay. So for the hands-on question, if you solve one question, so you will get interview call. Okay.
Yeah. According yes. to my research.
Okay. Okay.
So this is for all the activity details.
Yes.
So there are if you tell about the rounds and the panels, so there are three rounds in the interview section. First, okay. First is technical round, second is managerial round, and third is HR round.
Okay.
So technical and managerial, in my interview, there are two panelists, technical okay. and managerial for technical and managerial round. So my interviews were held on 23, and okay. there are two panelists, technical and managerial round.
Yes.
So the interviews. Yeah, so interview is done virtually, and in the technical round, first of all, we should have a government ID for verification.
Okay.
The starting of the interview. Yeah.
Okay. So in that, the TR round itself means they check the government ID proof in the technical round itself.
Yeah. Yes. Any of the government ID for verification, like PAN card, okay. Aadhaar card.
Okay.
Yeah. This type of government ID proof we should take.
Yes.
So yes. there are two rounds. So first of all, like every interview, they will ask you for introduce yourself.
Yes.
So, yeah. And after that, after that, some of the questions like which programming language do you prefer or which programming language do you learn?
Yes.
And yes, and basically many questions from your projects, like which projects.
Yes. Which projects you done?
Completed any certification and mentioned your resume. Yeah.
Yes.
And if you have completed any certification and mentioned your resume, then some questions from resume like I have completed a certification in cloud computing. So they okay. ask many questions from cloud, like what basic questions.
Okay, so like basic questions cloud. That you mentioned in the resume yeah. itself.
Resume. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
And
okay.
And 30 to 50% questions are asked from my project, like what is the role of you. What role you perform in your project and which technology use you to prepare your project or development. And there are some managerial questions like if we have a project and time limit is 1 year and you cannot perform better and you cannot complete this project in 1 year, then okay. how you will convince the client? This type of questions in managerial round and some of the cross questions, why should yes. you? Why do you want to join TCS? And these type of questions are asked in managerial round, and mainly basic questions are asked from like OOPS concepts.
Okay.
Yeah, OOPS concepts. Three or four questions asked from the OOPS concepts. So I think the coding technical or managerial round is not too much hard if we have knowledge of basic coding and technical knowledge, and okay. that is mentioned in our CV. Yeah.
Okay. Yes. So what are the some questions that are related that you have said that the particular questions in TR and MR round from resume itself, or there are the some conditions questions or the particular conditions question. So if I talk about the level of TR and MR round, so level itself is the means not the difficult, it will be medium. So what is the actual level of TR and MR round itself if they both conduct in the particular panel?
So I think difficulty level is not too much high. It is moderate, I think, because if we have knowledge of coding skills and we have developed any project, then we should know about our project.
Okay.
And which type of technology we use or what is DBMS, what is data structure, what is this yeah. type of questions, the basic questions we should know in the technical round. And in the managerial round, some of the concepts like how we handle any condition in our industry.
Yeah, there are the questions, condition-based questions in the managerial round.
Managerial round. And some cross questions like why should we hire you, or this type okay. of questions is also asked in my managerial round.
Okay.
And some questions from my resume like is this certification is done by you, then what you learn, is that certification is paid or not, and okay. when you done, these type of cross questions can be also asked in the managerial round by the MR.
Okay.
Like if they said if they don't complete any certification and put into our CV, that we will confuse there. So they will ask cross questions in the managerial round.
Okay.
So,
what is the questions arises that there are so many students that completed technical and managerial round itself in the particular time, but they not got the HR mail till. So what is the time? What is the time between the particular technical and HR, technical MR and the HR interview?
So actually, after completing my technical and managerial round, I am also waiting for my HR mail, and I did not get for 2 days. So I thought I'm not selected in TCS.
Okay.
But after 2 days, I got my HR round mail.
Okay.
And after 2 days, I got my offer letter. So these all processes go like technical round and managerial round is done on 19th of March. And after that, the HR round is conducted on 23rd of March.
Okay.
So there is different of 4 days, and I am waiting for HR mail also.
Yes.
So in the HR round, there is not too many questions. Like there is only basic questions. Tell me about yourself and what do you know about TCS and why do you want to join TCS? These type of 3 or 4 questions are asked by HR. Okay. And after that, CV is verified my all the documents.
Okay.
Like how much you scored in
MCA. Okay, so what type of documents they verified in the particular HR round?
So first of all, they will ask for your highest qualifications certificate. Like for me, this is that is MCA, how much you scored in which year? Is there any gap certificate or not? If you have any gap, and after that, she will also notify you for the 1 year of bond of TCS. That is of 50,000.
Yes.
TCS. And they will also ask of all the certificates, there should be 60%+, that is criteria of TCS.
Okay.
So after document verification, I got after 2 days offer letter of my TCS that we have to accept in 7 days.
Okay. So what are, these are related to the some important suggestions that are related for the interview, that are very important for the interview. So friends, Ritesh shares the tips to crack the interview, and these are the some key suggestions that are very important for the interview. So please, Ritesh, you can continue.
Actually, I don't have too much experience in the interview, but according to me, if you are going for any interview, then first of all, we have to be confident and smile on face. Like
we
should not any hesitate face and
hesitate tense.
Because interviewer is also a human being, and he is also there for selecting people. And
this is very important
point. First of all, confident and a smile on face is very important.
Okay.
Yeah. And second one is read about the company and read about the company and the total details about the company, like in which year the company is established, how much work employees are working there, and what is the revenue of the company. These type of questions we should go through with the first of all when we going for interview, then we should know about that.
Okay.
So after that, we have to try if we are going to tell about our hobbies, then we should relate our field also in our hobbies. Like for me, web development and tearing down or disassembling the hardwares is my hobby.
Yes.
So for that, I can explain like I love disassemble gadgets and I love hardware. So after that, the interviewers relate that if you are loving the machines, then you also love the machine learning, I think.
Yes, yes.
So first, I think we have to set our hobbies like that is related to our field in which we have to work.
Okay.
And fourth one is that we have to explain our project much well, because if we have done any project, then we can explain that thing more well, and they will ask questions from our project and we can answer confidently.
Okay.
And answer should be point to point. Not if we don't know about that, then we should also, sorry, I don't know about that.
Okay.
But I will research about that.
Yes, it is very important point.
Yeah.
Yes.
So according to these points, we should cover on our interview.
Okay.
That would be helpful.
Yes. Yes. So let's move on to the next point. What is the feedback to online learning channel? As Ritesh, we are talk from so many days during your whole preparation and during your whole interview experience. So what is your feedback to online learning channel?
So first of all, your channel is too much good for
thank
all
you
the
so much. Thank you so much.
Students and interns. Yes. And because I'm also confused in my starting days, like in the interview and when I completed my technical and managerial route, then okay. I also not convinced like I did get HR mail or not. So I also try to message you and you will reply fast on Instagram.
Yes.
So first feedback that is good for you, that is fast reply on all platforms. We can see all the comments of the YouTube section is also replied for you and your team.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Working too much good. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
And on your channel, we can also find out all the notification on campus drive, like in which campus when drive is held, or this type of notification we can get from your YouTube channel. And from your YouTube channel, I also find out some of the interview experience and regarding the interview, some of the notifications like and preparation tips from your channel, we can find out about the interviews. And notification, if there is any training like Google Cloud training, I get the notification from your channel like Google Cloud training is held and I have applied for that. So this type of notification I also got from your channel, like certification course and trainings. And after that, if anyone is not from the IT department, then he should also subscribe our channel, because on your channel there is government job notification also. If there is any government job or government job recruitment, then this type of notifications is also to find out from your channel. So your channel is too much good, and
thank you so much.
And everyone should subscribe this channel.
Thank you so much, Ritesh. Thank you so much, Ritesh, for your great feedback. As friends, you can see that this is the interview process, or this is the interview experience that Ritesh shared. And what are the some tips and suggestions that it will be useful for your interview preparation? Because many of the interview schedule in the next upcoming month or in the current month, and if the TCS hire in particular my month, so this video is very useful for the candidates. So if you also want to share your interview experience, you can just DM me on Instagram. There is a link in the description. Or if you have any doubt regarding interview experience or job update, just drop your query in comment section. Thanks for watching our videos.